Earning a place in the architectural record books is getting very specific these days. Tokyo Skytree is 200 meters shorter than the world's tallest building in Dubai, but its developers are still staking a claim to the structure being the tallest in its class.
At 634 meters, it's the world's biggest freestanding tower, and its creators say that it needs to be that high so that the tall buildings around it don't block the digital signals that it was built to carry. But with the recent spate of earthquakes, other architects disagree, and they say the future isn't vertical, it's linear.
I certainly think after 9/11 and certainly after the earthquake here, the tide is going to change. And I think it's just a logical progression, really. The need for a building which is a symbol, a symbolic building, that is kind of dying away today.
Skytree's developers disagree. They've incorporated several safety measures which they say will protect the more than $800 million tower from quakes and typhoons. Key parts of the steel frame are twice the standard strength. At the center, a reinforced concrete pole that separates from the tower after the first 125 meters.
The vibration is different inside of the concrete pole and the outside of Tokyo Sky Trees. So if you receive a big vibration by earthquakes, it's like two different waves of the vibration. It's reduced almost 50%.
Across town, at just under half the height of Skytree, the city's original broadcast tower is still dazzling tourists with a nightly light show. The 54-year-old Tokyo Tower is even getting a facelift. Workers are straightening the top section bent by last year's quake. Mike Firn, Al Jazeera, Tokyo.